Isso é inegável, né? E começou lá com seus caras sendo vencido, deixando o moleque na porta lá do Germânia para jogar bola. Aí, futebol mundial nunca mais foi o mesmo. É o grande gênio, primeiro.
To sidestep the kicks of his white opponents, Arthur developed a unique swiftness. He astounded fans and opponents alike. São Paulo, 2006, home of the only living man who saw Arthur Friedenreich play. Radio reporter Nicolau Tuma, 94, has seen them all. Garrincha, Pelé, Ronaldinho, and that forgotten superstar, Arthur Friedenreich.
Arthur Friedenreich foi o mito do começo do futebol no Brasil. Nós estávamos começando. Era um futebol restrito a poucas pessoas e a poucos grupos.
The name Arthur Friedenreich became an overnight legend in Brazil. In the final of the South America Championship in 1919, Brazil beat the then all-powerful opponents from Uruguay 1-0. Arthur scored the deciding goal and took Brazil to its first international title. Brazil's newspapers reported a football match on the front page for the first time. From then on, awestruck players, opponents and fans called him the Tiger with the Golden Foot.
Por essa viagem no tempo, você via que ele estava superior a, assim, tanto é que a imprensa brasileira de esporte, ela era só o turf, eram os cavalinhos. O futebol ganhou um destaque com Friedenreich. Isso é interessante. Antes era no finalzinho da folha do jornal, com Fred passou a ser manchete do jornal.
But for all his success, Friedenreich's story is the sad tale of a black player struggling for recognition. He didn't want the white spectators to recognize his African roots straight away. He was the first black player on the Brazilian national team and had to flatten his frizzy hair with pomade and a hairnet to avoid racist antagonism off the pitch. But on the pitch, Arthur had the right answer to racism. One day, he made a brilliant discovery. While practicing shots at goal, he managed to give the ball a curved trajectory. The curling kick was born. Scientists at Cologne University demonstrate the curl with the help of German national team member Marcel Janssen. He curls the ball while high-speed cameras and sensors record its unusual path. The secret of the curling kick lies in rotation. The ball spins several times around its own axis and, as a result, changes direction in flight. Departing from its straight path, it flies in a curved trajectory. Today, Arthur Friedenreich's discovery is part of the technical repertoire of the world's elite kick takers. The highlight of Friedenreich's career was the first European tour by a Brazilian national team. This is the only footage of him playing. It was taken at a match against a French team in Paris in 1919. The Brazilians won 7-2. Friedenreich was the goal scorer and man of the match. No one in Europe had ever seen football played at such a high level. The most striking player on the Brazilian team, Arthur Friedenreich.
Ele transformou o futebol em algo novo. Tanto é que era tão novo que deixou os franceses boquiabertos com um jogo. Com um jogo ele foi coroado o rei dos reis do futebol mundial. Um jogo.
Roland Loy is a sports scientist. He studies football games according to scientific criteria and researches historical football tables.
Arthur Friedenreich hat ja die beachtliche Anzahl von immerhin 1329 Toren erzielt. Damit hat er mehr Treffer geschossen als zum Beispiel der große Pelé oder aber auch Gerd Müller. Außerdem ist ja Arthur Friedenreich der erste Mensch gewesen, der die 1000-Tore-Marke knacken konnte.
Friedenreich played at the top level till he was 43. Nikolai Tuma still remembers the commentaries.
PRB 9 na torre agora, bom, São Paulo, transmitido do campo do Palmeiras, o patrocínio da equitativa dentro da sociedade, de 30 segundos de vida, 1, 2, 3, avançou, caminhão, driblou, 2, 3, chutou e gol! Assim.
Friedenreich's skills with the ball never earned him any money, but his grateful club gave him this house in São Paulo. He died, age 77, in November 1969. 11 days earlier, church bells had sounded throughout the land when Pele scored his 1,000th goal against Vasco da Gama. In the end, though, not even Pele could match the Tiger.
Futebol foi criado, inventado pelos ingleses, um esporte que chamou a atenção do mundo inteiro, logo conquistou o mundo inteiro de partida. Agora, sem ser internado no manicômio, eu digo, Friedenreich reinventou o futebol.
Então, ele foi um ídolo na época. Ele criou uma ideia maior do futebol. E o nome dele, penetrando pelas emissoras de rádio da época, ele começou a penetrar em todas as camadas sociais da nossa terra. E ele deu ao povo em geral a ideia de que seria possível a um homem simples alcançar a glória.
Friedenreich, one of football's best-kept secrets, was buried in the Athletes' Cemetery in São Paulo. The first football star, the inventor of the curling kick and the top-scoring goal kicker of all time, Arthur Friedenreich. In Friedenreich, Brazil had the greatest player of all time. But would he have become a superstar today? Could yesterday's heroes have cut it with today's professionals? Three players from the German first division club Hamburger SV are performing a test. They are demonstrating their technique, ball control and shooting prowess with balls and boots like the ones they'll be using in the World Cup. But how good would their technique be in the boots of yesteryear? Just how much difference do the new materials make? To find out, our pros put on 60-year-old boots and tried the same exercises with a vintage ball. The results were clear enough. In the days when the ball was made of real leather and steel toe caps were sewn into the boots, the players needed excellent technique.
Ja, für mich Schuh zum Arbeiten. Dann kann man keinen Halt auf dem Rasen, weil es keine richtigen Stollen sind. Und nach ein paar Minuten habe ich schon irgendwie Blasen gefühlt, dass ich welche bekomme.
La différence c'est que bon, ils sont tous les deux bien légers. À part que maintenant le vieux ballon, s'il pleut, ben, il va devenir beaucoup plus lourd et il va être beaucoup plus difficile de jouer avec.
À gérer, mais je pense que les joueurs, les anciens joueurs avaient pas mal de techniques parce que c'est assez difficile avec ce genre de ballon et ce genre de chaussures de jouer. Donc j'ai beaucoup de respect pour eux.
Equipment has sometimes been decisive in football. In 1954, the West Germans became the world champions by unexpectedly beating the favorites, Hungary, 3-2. In our quest for the greatest football nation, we cannot ignore the town of Scheinfeld. For this Bavarian town has influenced football history many times over. It is the home of Adidas. Karl-Heinz Lang had a part in all the key developments of the Adidas boot and was a friend and advisor to the Adidas founder, Adi Dassler.